What is going on, boys and girls of YouTube? We're getting back into the actual content grind. I said you'd probably be seeing more content, definitely from me, that is YouTube specific, than you've probably ever seen coming out, starting literally with like the video yesterday and today's video. Probably gonna try to just slaughter everybody in the content. Hopefully this is what you guys are wanting. Hopefully this is what you like. If there's any content specifically you are asking for or you're wanting, you have to tell me. Put it in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit the like button. Hopefully you guys like the new setup. Slowly getting it to where I want it to be. So we're gonna go ahead and jump into this. This is gonna be a play-by-play day. It's gonna be Pele because I've had one of my viewers ask, I think 21 days in a row, he's done hashtag Pele play-by-play, PP, I believe. So that's happening. On top of all that, the hoodie is on pre-sale right now. Very, very high quality. I'll be shipping out myself. It's from a different company that makes the masks, but the quality is fucking ridiculous. There's only going to be 100. There's only 40 left as of right now. 60 people from stream have grabbed it since I promoted it on stream last night. If you want it, link is below. It's weekend.shop and it'll pop right up. That's where the masks are. That's where the hoodies are going to be. Pre-sale. Go ahead and get your pre-sale. They will be shipped out and hopefully you will have them by middle of December. I'm ordering them tonight and then they will ship out as soon as I get them the next day. So there it is. Go ahead and jump into this. Get some gaming going. We're playing Pele, as I mentioned. Pele is in an interesting place because she's definitely balanced. I would not at all argue that she's balanced in any way, shape, or form. She's definitely balanced. But if you get the right early pressure, you're almost unstoppable. When you get the CDR online, so your ult is always up, you feel pretty much unstoppable. And it's a really, right now, especially in the jungle, there are many gods that it can give you that feeling. And we're going to hope that with this game, that's what happens. If not, either way, we'll go into it and we'll talk about what we're doing. Build-wise, you are looking at a standard ability build. They don't have any healing, really, other than Cthulhu and his ultimate. So anti-heal isn't necessary. It isn't 100% have, but it's still a good item. It'll stop Hachi, it'll stop Mulan's healing. If Ymir goes healing, it'll stop that, even though I think he's support. And then it'll stop Cthulhu healing when he's in his ultimate. It has value. That being said, it doesn't have insane must fucking build value, so you're not going to see me rushing it. Did I say Bloodforge? I think I might have said Bloodforge. Brawlers. Hopefully I said Brawlers. Talking about Brawlers. Anti-heal. We're not going the Brawlers rush right away. If we fall behind before I can finish my Jotuns, then we might build it just because that's how it is. And if this was an SPL game or a really, really high level game, you would probably see me go Brawlers right after Boots. I'm going for the CDR. I want to go Jotuns. I want to carry this game. That's my goal. So that's that. That's the build plan. So we know what we're doing ahead of time. You start with your three on Pele. The clear is even to the one, if not a little bit better. Plus, it allows you to get over to the blue a little bit faster and be active in that blue kill. Something to note, something to remember. It's nice having the Morgan. Her clear is really good. So there's that. That's dead. Gonna let it build up for a second. And then we're just gonna pop it on rank one to get over to the blue buff. We're gonna tone it down here now that it's ending. Let it build up again. And we're just gonna kill this with Chunga. Get active, be a part of it. And it's dead. Boom. Easy peasy. Come over to the mids, the back. Sorry, I don't know why I always call these mids, and I don't know why it's stuck in my head. Do that, level up the one, and then we're cleared. And we have more than like, oh, it looks like Ymir is the jungler. So this is gonna be a lot more difficult not having beads. We have to play smart as hell. Probably could have, nice, really good poke here. Just great fucking poke. I kind of could have blinked on the Thoth because he's still a one and gained that pressure, that kill, but it doesn't matter. We still full clear. Ymir went aggressive for no reason, and we invade the red buffs 100%. There's no doubt here because of Thoth's early pressure not being there, and the fact that I have a Morgan who is high pressure. There's big value in this. I also want to look for a kill here. I'm gonna try to. He just uses two, so I'm gonna blink across. Get active in this. I'm gonna let him stun me. We don't care. As long as Morgan comes, we don't care. His two is coming up. We juked it, and he should die. Unless he has blink, but his blink is down. We should kill him in one. Boom, boom. Easy kill. Then we turn around. We get a triple knockup.
We didn't even knock him up. Oh no, the misplay, boys.
I think his dash is done. And we got a double kill. Ends up working out. As I said, as soon as we saw the Ymir 2, which is really all of Ymir's damage, we didn't have much to worry about going in 1v2. It's also a Thoth, low pressure. Morgan hadn't come, we would have been fucked. We would have been in a predicament. I'm glad to get this pressure though. Like this move. Oh no. This Mulan is huge. That was a really bad misplay from him. I should be okay though. That was a misplay from my mid laner. He should have backed as soon as he leveled 1 health. Watch me blink. Taking names from World of Warcraft mage players. Feels bad. Feels real bad. Unless it's him. Unless it's... I forget what his name is. Was a big streamer for a little while. Anyway, the full reset. We are down a lot. Like, even though I'm up, this support Mulan is huge. Plus side, it's support. Minus side, it's a Mulan support who with pressure is a very scary thing to deal with. It's not going to be easy to kill this person. A lot of people always ask me, what do you level up? What abilities? I like leveling up the one for the burst, especially since I go the CDR build. Oh, we're going to get active over here. We get a kill here for sure. There's no way he lives. I'm not going to keep chasing here. We're going to secure the blue and just be happy with that. We have 3 kills. We're keeping up with the support Mulan and we are that Pele that we were talking about, the pretty much just run it down, run it at him. I'm gonna wish I had anti-heal for the Mulan. So early support Mulan, I tell people to play this and Hercules if they want to carry games. It allows you to do so fucking much for your team. At the same time, if you play stupid like this, it doesn't allow you to do too much. This guy might end up dying here. He doesn't have his ultimate. I don't want to waste my ult since he doesn't have his ult, so we're just gonna go ahead and try to get that kill. Good secure by the Cthulhu. Would have much rather been my kill. Oh, beads, nice. Juke it. Gonna get the knock up. We might be able to get a double kill. Oh no, we're not gonna get a single kill. I fucked up. Misplay. I tried to position there to hit the Thoth with an auto and the one, so maybe I could go for a double kill, but it was a misplay. I should have just secured. Don't ever get ahead of yourself when you're playing. Like, do your best to not get ahead of yourself, meaning don't try to think too far. Don't try to do too much. It kind of happens a lot when people play gods like Hunbats and shit. They go for like multi-ults. You don't need multi-ults. You don't need multi-kills. Killing the Ymir there would have had immense value. The double kill would be nice, but it doesn't. Like, getting one kill is fucking awesome. It is absolutely fucking awesome, especially when you already have 3 kills. So just take it step by step. Go for the single kill and be smart about it. Looks like he's being pressured under my tower. This dude is being full on bullied, bro. And I think his red's just gone. I might go over there. I'm gonna try to secure this and go over there. I think it's gonna be gone though. I'm assuming he's sitting on it. I didn't pick up my speed either. That was a misplay. My Morgan is being bullied. I'm not going straight to it. Too many creeps here to miss. Always pick up waves whenever you go by. If your teammates die, always pick them up. I don't know what this guy's doing. It's smart of him to be aggressive, but like, I don't know why. I don't have boots, so I'm not gonna force anything. My dude should be able to secure his blue. He's good now. We kept him away from that first gank. We are gonna go Ninja Tabby. Every time I'm playing gods like this and they're like, why do you have Ninja Tabby? If I'm not going Crusher, I want attack speed from something. My ultimate is about getting those autos off, those 4 autos off as fast as possible and doing that damage. I want auto attack or attack speed from something. I'm not getting Crusher. I'm going to go Jotun's here. So we're going to go ahead and pick it up. We got a really good engage here. This is a potential triple kill. This guy just bamboozled me. I'm misplayed. I should have swapped targets and let my Cthulhu get some kills. He can knock him out. It's huge. He should be able to kill him. There should be a kill there. There's no way they don't kill him. It's one auto. He died for it though, I think. That was a good engage. For me, like, I had a really good engage there. They overcommitted on the tower. If you can play like I'm playing as a jungler, you're pretty much in optimal positioning at all times, letting your team be the ones that are engaging and doing dumb shit, and then playing around that. My Morgan's getting farmed, but she's not bad at all. Like, she's doing a really good job. We're gonna disengage here. We don't have beads. If this Thoth isn't an idiot, he knows that. They're stuck in this weird W key fight mode right now. If he stuns, I'm gonna go pressure out. Is he diving? Oh my gosh, he blinked him again. This guy is just fighting the whole game. He's gonna turn on him. Nice fucking job, dude. This dude is playing like a beast. My Morgan dying, but still fucking playing, right? He's got really good jukes. I love it. I fucking love it. For the mid to late game, targeting is going to be mainly, if Ymir's out of position, and his stun's down, we're gonna kill Ymir. If he's in our face, we're gonna kill him. Otherwise, we're looking for probably the Hachi or the Thoth. The Thoth is a really easy dive. Even right now, he's a really easy dive. I think I can get a kill here. Yeah, we get a kill here for sure. Fantastic. The Thoth would be really easy kills in the mid and late game. And he really needs to be shut down. He can't go over walls or anything. The Hachi's ultimate can get him just enough out of range of a Pele if he plays correctly. But the Thoth is guaranteed chase down. Like, we guarantee chase this guy down. I want to fight this. Hopefully my Chunga comes. I have to save my ultimate for the Ymir. Hey, this guy's dead. I have to save ult for Ymir stun right now since I don't have beads. Notice how I'm actively thinking about what happens if someone else comes. You need to be doing that as a jungler whenever you're ganking. Is could someone come? If you aren't 100% sure of where they are, then the answer is probably yes. And if the answer is yes, how are you going to play, or what do you have to do to play around that person coming? We have a lot of gold, so we don't want to overstay right now. A lot of farm still on the map. A lot of mid farm, like the mid harpies are up. But we want to get this item online and be able to fight as soon as possible. I am going to go a lifesteal build here, because them applying divine from jungle and mid doesn't stack. Two divines don't stack. So they're not going to have brawlers. There's no way, unless Mulan goes brawlers, they won't have physical anti-heal this game. So my lifesteal will have a lot of value even when they build anti-heal, because they can't get the right kinds of anti-heal. So we're going to go sustain, and then we're going to go Hydra. So we have the continuous poke on our targets. I don't know what this guy's doing. Like, I do a lot of damage. I don't think this guy realized. I really don't think this guy realizes. He's going to try to ult out here. There's no way he doesn't. And I'm going to try to save my ult for the Ymir. Never mind. He doesn't have his ult, looks like. We'll just take the kill and get out. Be happy with it. I do not want to fight because I don't have beads. The Ymir knows I don't have beads. Okay, I don't really know what's going on. I was going to blink on the Thoth, but I guess not. We can kill here. We can get a double kill here too. Oh, he got enough to dash, but I think he dies to Cthulhu. I'm going to go in and try to get this kill. A little bit of a kill steal there, boys, but you know, it is what it is. I want the fucking kills, dude. I have 9 kills and 4 assists, and my solo laner just soloed. Nice shit. This is a crazy game. So this is one problem I have with current Smite. Smite's in a great place. The game is extremely balanced. There's 100 gods you can play, and they all are viable and valuable and useful. But the game has turned into a fight fest, because no matter what, you have a good chance of being in a position to win late game. No matter what, no matter how many fights you lose in the early game, you always have a chance at winning your late game. People know it, so it turns into an arena match. We're 10 minutes in, and there's 25 kills in this match. In the game, we're up 5k, but realistically, we can't be comfortable. We can't assume, like, that doesn't mean we win. It means really nothing. I'm gonna try to get to this guy, but he's kind of in a bad position. I want my team to group on this corner. I'm gonna hope they path in. Doesn't look like they're going to. They're gonna go secure the blue buff. But we're huge. We get our second active now, get our beads and be comfortable. I'm gonna drop his blue, even though he can't pick it up. I don't want Ymir rotating into this side of the map and getting them free farm. Also dropping wards. I haven't been warding enough this game. When you're fighting this much, even when you have an advantage, there's a good chance that you make a mistake, a big abilities missed or something for the first time in the game, and you lose a team fight. You lose a team fight, turns into objective. Your whole lead's gone. In the blink of an eye, it's just gone. Like, it was like you never had it, and you're wondering why we were winning this game. How are we losing now? It happens a lot more than you would think. So make sure you're warding. Maybe slow down in the fighting a little bit once that thought like crosses your mind, like, hey, if we lose a fight, we lose the game. So let's chill, let's group up, let's play around objectives, and then just start being the ones going for the objectives all the time. I mean, our lead 3k. I think it wasn't it just 5k. So yeah, our lead just got chopped down a little bit. If I die, they're going to get like an 800 gold boost. So I need to position really properly. You have to be smart when you are the one with the lead. This is so weird. We're fighting on their tower line right now without me, which I really don't like. But, you know, that just is what it is. If I dive this, we lose. So I can't dive here. Oh, this guy's fucked. Free kill. I'm not afraid to fight at all. We know a lot was just used, and we know their health is very low. So we're just not going to stress over it. We're going to look, see if anybody stayed. Doesn't appear to be so. They have vision on the Gold Fury, so we can't force anything on that. Mulan might try to do something to Medusa, so I'm going to play around that possibility. Oh, it's gone now. So we're going to do gold. So their vision just dropped. Yes, they can rotate. Yes, they can be here. Oh, no, Chunga, please. I want to do gold, but if Chunga's being pressured out, I have to go to mid. I'm going to go to this. I'm feeling pretty confident. If we get the stall, this pretty much GG too. He didn't even get his dash off. I want to do gold. I just want to do gold. I have to be the one to be like, let's do a fucking objective. Because if I'm the one telling you guys, hey, we should be doing objectives, and I'm not doing them, it looks pretty fucking stupid. I'm going to fight this. Oh, that was a good ult. Let's go to gold. I don't know why he's body blocking me. Like, I'm trying to walk around you with a speed buff and you won't let me. We wasted ult there, but the smart thing to do is not to force it down. As soon as Cthulhu ulted, there's no guarantee we can do anything. So just take the win. Grab your own buffs after you do gold, or when you do gold, do your buffs, and then back is usually the move because you have so much gold. So I'm going to try to get my Hydras online here. It's not going to be quite enough, I don't think. And then I'm going to go over to fire. Because any good team is going to be doing fire when you're doing gold fury. We're not quite there. I don't want to back yet. I'm doing a greedy move here. No ultimate, so I could waste bees. I don't know why we're around the gold fury. There's no reason to be there. This is crazy, though, how these fights, like, look at how low they are, right? I'm rotating in this fairly healthy with beads up, ult up in 10. If my ult was up right now, this would be beautiful. So this is still risky as fuck and probably going to be me wasting my beads, but, you know, we're going to play around it. We're going to try to grab Mulan here. He knew I was here, so this is actually really bad. Got that kill. My ult's back up, so we're not scared of shit right now. Yeah, we're chilling. That was a great Medusa ult, and we get another fucking kill. Beautiful fucking play from Medusa. Risky play. Me being there for no reason, no objectives, nothing to gain. Medusa showing up made that shit not risky at all. That was fucking beautiful. We need to go and get fire. They're blaming Chunga for shit, but they shouldn't have been there fighting. There was no reason to be fighting anymore. We did gold, like, what? A whole minute before they were there dying at gold? There's nothing. Oracles don't matter. Nothing matters. There's no gold for 5 minutes, so you're chilling. I'm going to try to get deep vision right now, and then post up and spam, like, let's do fucking fire. I'm going to call for the fire now, so my Medusa knows to come to this side of the map. He already has his wave pushed out, so there's no downside to being around the fire right now. I don't want to get picked because I don't have beads or ultimate. That's a risky thing I have to know. So I'm going to get these wards out, make it as safe as possible, and pull this bitch. Should be free. If this guy comes in, we just fucking bamboozle his ass. Make it so he can't do anything. Paul's going to steal it. Oh, we got it. Nice. I'm okay with fighting if there's no stuns up. There goes stun. So we're okay with looking for a fight here. Just trying to CC. Thoth just dash. This guy's obsessed with me for whatever reason. So we're going to play around that. We're just disengaging. We want to go on the Thoth. Thoth is our target. Oh, that was a great stun. He played that corner well. I'm going to die here. They're going to gain a lot of gold. Oh, they haven't killed me yet. There we go. Medusa being in right is a big bamboozle for us. If I got my blink off, that would have been better, but him catching me was a bad fight. I should have looked for a disengage with my ultimate and just played smart. Definitely a I want to get all the kills type of play. I mean, I do have 14 kills, but like I said, I just gave them so much gold. They are very low. These should be kills for Chunga. Chunga, attack. 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 Attack, Chunga, please. Chunga, you have short CDR. You have short cooldowns. Short cooldowns. Attack, bro. Chunga, please. Oh my gosh, this guy's scared. I don't know why. Frustrating. We are going a full ability build. In terms of like what I'm focusing on. Now, for my item after this Heartseeker, I want penetration. You're usually looking at serrated. We'll go into this. We're either looking at serrated edge or we are looking at Titan's Bane. Serrated edge will never proc because of your... Well, it will proc, but you can't get all the procs because your three just never goes on cooldown. And the item is still very good, and I still like the item a lot. So you have to go ahead and pay attention to, is that first burst of damage that you get from having the Titan's Bane passive worth the extra? Is that extra 20%? That is a lot. Like, an extra 20% is a lot, but is it worth on Pele to trade off that for the movement speed and the extra lifesteal and the same? Well, you have the same amount of power. You have to look at it like that. I think because of how these fights are going and how I'm just insta-killing somebody, I am going to go ahead and grab the Titan's Bane. I think my ultimate, if that's what I end up using first, will pretty much insta-kill somebody. And I have to remember to play around that. And if it's not, then I use my one on it, and that just is what it is. Also have to remember, I do not advance. I go for this guy. Attack fire giant. Group up. I don't know what they're doing. That beads up. We could kill so easily if we group. Have to get them to group. I get a lot of you guys complaining, like, I can't get my teammates to group up, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I mean, it's hard sometimes. Like, even this game, you see these guys just don't want to. That just is what it is. I'm gonna ult out here. I'm gonna play the smart move. Thoth also just dashed in. They killed him, which is beautiful. Thoth is looking for me, which is awkward. If he dashes again, I'm gonna go on him. If I see him dash, like, up here and being stupidly aggressive, I'll just turn on him. A life steal will keep me alive. Don't have to worry about that, though. Gonna grab a counter ward. Looks like our Medusa is not about grouping this game. Dude, this is nuts. I've been a part of 20 over 25 kills, and I mean, my Morgan, like I said, he's doing decent. He's died a lot, but he's doing decent. Gold being up. This is a big Gold Fury. Whenever you see the Oni Fury up, you have to really, like, acknowledge that. Pay attention to it. Think of how valuable that is, how much pressure that gains for you. And think of it almost like you got Fire Giant, you have Oni Fury, and then everything else. Like, that's literally the order of importance. So make sure you process that. Also, me picking up red buff right now would be massive. I hate speed buff in Smite game. It's terrible. And if I were to get red right now... Ooh, look at this guy. A little opposition here, Buckaroo. Should get a free kill here. He's a great Aegis. Oh, that was a sick pull, dude. Too bad I saw him on the ward in the back. We want to get out of this. I don't want to force anything here. But I don't have to. Bro, just do anything you guys want. Free cast on this idiot. I don't know what we're so afraid of. My Medusa is in base. Please just group up for the love of God. We need to group up here. This game should be over. If this was good players, this game's over. Like, there's no chance it's not over. I'm going to probably scratch the... What's it called here? The... I always forget the... Like I said, I keep forgetting the name. Titan's Bane. We're going to go Brawlers and then sell Boots for Titan's Bane. We're definitely going to do that. I want this Mulan to not heal at all. How much regen is he sitting on? Oops. How much HP 5 we got here? 61 HP 5. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm going to tell them to go to gold. Do you see their team posted up around fire? Come on, Medusa, please. I don't know. Wake up, bro. We're going to play around the fire. Oh, shit. Yo, group up. He just wasted his ult. It hit my fucking idiot. We're gonna play back here a little bit. We need to be grouped. This Medusa has to be in this fight. He's getting run at by Ymir. And my dogs, I have the zoomies behind me. I can hear them just zooming around. Going nuts. I would love for my teammates to tank this. Can you get out? That Thoth hit us. I don't really know how the fuck he just max ranged me. That was scary as hell. We're gonna disengage. It looks like I have to be the one pulling objectives, which is not ideal for me in this situation. Because I do, I should build defense. If I was playing properly, if I were you guys, I would recommend building defense, knowing that you have to be the ones pulling the objectives. I'm not doing that shit. I want to keep carrying. I'm gonna do my best to, like, go in, hit an objective so that my teammates start tanking it and pulling it, and then just fucking doing whatever I want. My Chen is also split pushing his ass off right now. Oh, that's an attack mid lane. Yeah. This is a Phoenix. My team kind of wiping. This should be a Phoenix, especially if we kill Mulan. With the healing and Mulan being fucking over here stuck. Yeah, we clap him. You cannot kill me. It's impossible for him to kill me right now. We just want to make sure he stays in combat. We're gonna ult him. Like I said, if he dies, it's good. It's great. Having one less person. All right. Can we attack fire? Where? Like, I don't know where my... I don't know where Medusa's going. They won't do objectives, boys. How to get your team to do objective fucking play-by-play, and I cannot get my teammates to do objectives. This Medusa doesn't want to listen. Hey, I like this. I really do. And I always tell you guys, you can still win these games. Clearly, you can still win these games. But you have to do so much more work to get a free win. We could have had fire in this game over already if Medusa would just screw up. He's doing Chad. I'm going to keep pinging him. Like, I'm going to keep being annoying. He can either mute me or fucking play the game properly, you know? Oh, that's a good fucking dude. This Thoth is being like, he's not doing good, to be honest. But defensively and to be annoying, like he's doing a good job being like slightly annoying. But he's not having a good game at all by any means. We have our anti-heal now. Let's see what Ymir went. Ymir is going a tankier hybrid build. Thoth doesn't have any sustain. So really this Brawlers is for Hachi and it's for Mulan. And I'm not first killing Mulan in any team fights. That's not what buying Brawlers means. It just means I have it. Or if any of my abilities hit him, he's anti-healed. He's not sustaining as much. And I also can kill the Hachi. All right, Medusa finally coming left. 2, 5, and 4. Oh my gosh, he has a soul eater. We're gonna back off. We do not want to force anything here. Oh, that's not good. I'm not fighting that. This is good. This is great. So I'm gonna split off this. If this guy wants to fight me, like he's gonna catch the clapper straight up. Are you fucking bamboozling me with a dash? That was beautiful. I'm still gonna push out mid. I'm gonna try to sustain. Hachi a little low. He's gonna go. He'll sustain off my team. Sadly. At least we sustain. The lifesteal comes into play. I don't know who will back here to defend this. It's Thoth. I have my ult up. I dive him and I kill him and I take the Phoenix. I'll probably get very low, but it's still easy. With no ult up, I have to play very smart here. I did not want to die to him. This is risky. I might have to use my beads. He missed his root. I got that red. I want to pick that red up. That's why I did that. I wasn't trying to go for the Thoth kill here. I just really want that red buff. I can't hit an ability anyway. It's all good. Carry me, team. Oh no, dude. He hits that over the fucking wall. This is so stupid. We have to get out of this. Oh, that's a great fucking play. Oh my gosh, dude. That was a misplay for me. It was greedy for me to go for red buff. Misplay for me, but my team has a 4v2 because I killed Ymir and they're losing it. So I can be annoyed with them. I can be annoyed myself. Whatever. You might as well just keep fucking playing it out because nothing's happening here. I'm going to play the rest of this game as a split pusher. Medusa doesn't want to do objectives. I don't think he knows what he's building, which is really weird. Like this is an ability build, but it's not an ability build. The Soul Eater came out of left fucking field. Morgan, on the other hand, has a solid one-shot build, is definitely gonna tap, needs a soul. Oh, she just swapped. She died? Oh shit, she just died. She needs a Soul Reaver, but she's got a solid one-tap build. Chunga's got a little bit of damage. So if I play around the Morgan mainly and ignore the Medusa and play like a 4v5, we'll be okay. We'll be all good. I have cap CDR, but red pot's just too much to pass up. I'm gonna upgrade my beads here and my blink, so when I do go in, they can't just focus me down easily. I really wanted that red buff. I really, really wanted that red buff, man. Cthulhu is just so frustrating. I had to beads his bullshit and then get feared in the wall anyway. Oh, okay. They left one creep. That's that small wee wee shit. Oh, this guy's dead. He'll wall me and then I'll blink it. This is my goal. I want him to wall. Oh, he's not gonna wall. Okay. This is awkward. He's fast. Zoom more, boys. Alright, that's fine. We've upgraded blink. There's no way he has upgraded blink. We don't have beads. We gotta play smart here. That team's trying to do gold fury awkwardly. This Mubizi dude has thorns, is annoying as fuck. And he has anti-heal. Okay. Why is he hasn't gone double anti-heal? Bro, this guy's full HP doing Chad. This is a good positioning for me, though. Not having beads sucks. They're going to path underneath. They're running away. Get a knock off. He does. Okay. Oh, good pull from that dude. That's a great pull from that dude. Oh, he hit the max range ult. I thought I was out of there. I thought I was gone, dude. I must have done a lot of damage to myself. It didn't. A little bit, but not a lot. Oh, he just whiffed Chungle. We're gonna lose this game, boys.
Can you just AFK under the tower?
I know the Morrigan's not okay. Oh, this jungle is strong. I think he's friends with him. And I'm asking this so maybe I can be like, yo, get your friend to like actually play the game, please, because this is annoying. This is so hard. Can't do anything. Alright, I'm gonna go there. They should push out left a wave or two, but then they should go right if they want to win the game. They're gonna push down our right. So I'm gonna try to push out left and do that split pushing shit I was talking about. I really don't want this guy to see me. I'm gonna try to zoom in here and hug the wall. I don't wanna go in the jungle though, because I don't know where their wards are. 18 kill game, and we're probably not even gonna win. I think Chunga and Medusa have to be friends. They literally have to be. I don't know if I kill Cthulhu. It should be close, but with Fire Giant, I don't know if I kill him. I also don't even know if I kill Mulan. Like, the Thorns is really hard to play around right now. Oh, shit, gank this guy. Oh, it did almost one-shot me, dude, and I don't have my shit up. Fucking A, bro. They all came left. That was smart of them. Kind of weird they're wasting a lot of their Fire Giant, but really smart for them to just stop me from split pushing. They know if they kill me, the game's over. Like, if I'm dead, we can't win.
Retreat, retreat.
He just missed every auto. Oh no, hit an auto, buddy. Please, Medusa. Just kill. Please, Medusa. He got a kill. I'm up before we lose here, but he need. Oh, two kills would have been so nice, dude. This is a rough game, boys. I have beads up. I'm gonna get a red pod here because I fucking have to. Oh, he's dead. He's dead. Oh, Juke. I don't have my fucking shit up. Oh, he still has fucking Thorns. That's so bad. I thought I, or it's not his Thorns, his Aegis. I thought I could kill him. I went for a hero play there. Tried to go for a kill on the Thals with no dash and then end the game. Like, us push in and end the game. Him having Aegis made that impossible. That was a good save on his actives. I should have known he didn't have Aegis too. Like, there is no way he would have his Aegis down. They should have used code weak. This sucks. He just doubled his damage and defended. He fucking played the game, boys. Oh my god, this is one of those talk shit get hits for me. Talk shit about Medusa and he makes a play, bro. Holy fuck. Is that RNG or is he fueled by the fire? That's the real question. This Ymir is gonna go for an end. 1000%. I need to get a ward. I need to get multiple wards. That Titan has no health. They're dead for a long time, which is a plus. The Titan has a very, very low HP. And I don't have beats. I'd like to get a Magi's Blessing instead of fucking what's it called here, but I'm not gonna do that. He's by himself. He's gonna blink on me. Yep, that's what we wanted. We don't even care, dude. We secured red buff as well. It's his blink. He's gonna try to defend this. Oh, nice. I'll take a free red buff. So waste your mirror all. At least they don't have a chance of ending for the next like 45 seconds. Ish. They got right way pushed out too. Oh, this is hard. They're playing very grouped and very smart. Team fights, I need to try to separate the Thoth. But he is dashing in and being like grouped on his teammates, like playing, I'm not gonna say perfectly, but pretty fucking near perfectly. And I have to fucking recognize that. I can't even go in here, dude. It's rough. I would love to go in here, but I can't because I don't have my ultimate up. It's Small chance Hachi goes for purple. Don't think we're going to see it. Oh, this is... My team is doing a good job. Medusa. Oh, Gankman. That's fucking huge, boys. What are you even doing? Huge, boys. That's a game. We win. He's invisible. What the fuck is this? Bro, what? He's fucking invisible, dude. We have to end before this goes. Bro, this Medusa's trolling. Wait, we win. But we win. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, bro. My team won a 3v5 in the mid lane. Medusa was coming out of the base and I was over in the right. And they killed that dude, leaving Thoth for a free kill, leaving Hachi to a free kill, and then the game's fucking over. How? This is what I was saying in the beginning of the game. No matter what lead you have, it doesn't mean shit. Because you can always win a game, bro. I did 41k. I think Medusa legitimately did like 3k to 4k in that saving fight. Maybe a little bit less, but around 3k in that fight where he saved on Titan. And then he did absolutely nothing at the end. So I don't... I guess he was doing more. I don't think so, though. I think this is kind of bullshit. He did ward a lot. I'll take it, dude. All I got was a GG. That was a fucking wild game. Hopefully this play-by-play helps you out a little bit. I want to... recognize and point out that Medusa literally was doing nothing in the team fights. Like we have full on proof. If you're in a game and you are that Medusa, not like literally, like I'm not trying to talk to Medusa, but if you are a Medusa, like you are in that situation where you're not doing anything and your team is offering you advice and saying like, do basic stuff, come to the Gold Fury, group up. That's not being toxic. That is not even criticizing. It's telling you where you need to be for the team. And if you don't want to listen, honestly, team-based games might not be for you. Like, it literally might come down to just that. Especially if someone is carrying and they're like, bro, you have to group up, come over. And you're not doing it and they're pinging. And then you're like, bro, what are you doing? And you're not responding. That's not being toxic. You have to take credit. You have to acknowledge what's happening. And maybe not credit, sorry. You have to take responsibility, I guess, for your actions, for the things you're doing. And you need to do more when your team's asking you to do more. If you're not doing enough, they're telling you you're not doing enough, you're probably not doing enough. It just is what it is. So anyway, hopefully the play-by-play was what you guys wanted. Finally got that play-by-play done for Pele. I had fun. That was a wild fucking ending, I'll tell you that. I'll see you guys in the video later today, tomorrow, the next day, and all the other hundreds of videos we'll be putting up over the next few weeks and months and days and years. Have a good day, boys and girls. Make sure you're subscribed. Subscribe, hit the like, drop a comment, please. Thank you, guys.